Example 3, given q of x equals 1 half x squared plus 1, well, the parent graph is going to be y equals x squared. So we're going to list the correct order of transformations. There's only two, and they're both vertical, and the order absolutely matters because we need to multiply the y values before we add anything to them. So the first transformation has to be a vertical because that value is between 0 and 1 and it's on the outside of the x squared. It's a vertical compression by a factor of 1 half. And then we also have a vertical shift up 1 unit. So this order is important because we have two vertical transformations, one which involves multiplication and one which involves addition, and multiplication has to come before addition in the order of operations. So we have a vertical shift up 1 unit. So it's only two transformations, but it's important that we have that order correct. All right, so once again, I already mentioned that the parent graph is y equals x squared. And we know that looks like a parabola. And we have two things to do to the y values. So multiply y values by 1 half, then add 1. And that's it. We only have to operate on the y's. So remember, the parent graph is x squared. It looks like a U-shaped curve like that, a parabola. And we're going to show where the key points go after we do those two transformations. And what are our key points for x squared? Well, we have negative 1 and 1. We have the origin, and we have 1 and 1. And we know it looks like a smooth curve that opens up, otherwise known as a parabola. So, and we're not doing anything to the x values, so let me just jot down all of our x values. But we do need to multiply the y value by 1 half, so 1 times 1 half, and then add 1. That will be 3 halves. We multiply 0 times 1 half, we get 0, then add 1, so that will be 1. And once again, we're multiplying by 1 by 1 half and then adding 1, so we get 3 halves. So keep in mind that this will be a U-shaped curve that has slightly changed, but it still have that general shape. It's just not a rigid transformation because of the vertical compression. So when we graph these points, negative 1, and then 1.5, and then 0 and 1, and then 1 and 1.5, kind of make our U-shaped curve a little bit wider than what the parent graph would look. I kind of missed my 1 point, but I'll just make my dot wider to fix that. So we have negative 1 and 3/2. We have 0 and 1, and our last point there is 1/3/2. So this is a vertical compression by a factor of 1/2, so it makes the graph wider, it makes that U wider, and a vertical shift up 1 unit.